equal time point. As the name suggests, this is a point on our route from which we could either continue to our destination or return back to our departure airport, and it would take us the same amount of time to do so. Imagine we have a route segment of 200 nautical miles and a plane traveling with a true airspeed of 100 knots. We know that the time is equal to distance divided by speed, so this means it will take us 2 hours to reach the destination and only 1 hour to go halfway through the trip. Well, this is our equal time point in a situation with no wind. However, if we introduce wind, things change a little bit. For simplicity, let's say the wind is a pure tailwind, 270 at 30 knots. Observe that the equal time point in this case would shift to the west. This is because we have tailwind traveling east and a headwind traveling back west. So where exactly is the equal time point in this case? Let's start by defining what we already know. We have a true airspeed of 100 knots with a tailwind on the way down and a headwind on the way back. We can define these two speeds as VC, speed to continue, and VR, speed to return. Since it's pure tailwind and headwind, the speeds would be 130 and 70 knots respectively. We also know the total distance D. Let's call the distance to the ETP X and the rest of the distance simply as distance minus X. As we want the times to be the same for either continuing from ETP or returning from it, we can write a simple equation where the time to continue is equal to time of return. Time is equal to distance divided by the speed. So, to return, we need to cross distance x with the speed of we return, or to continue, we need to cross distance d minus x with the speed of we continue. We can cross multiply and get this. On the right side, we multiply both d and x with we return. Now we can transfer everything that contains x to the left side and everything else to the right. Isolating x on the left gives us this. We can now divide everything by we continue plus we return and get the value of x, which is our ETP distance from the departure airport. In this case, it would be equal to 70 nautical miles. So, after crossing 70 nautical miles, it would be quicker to continue for the next 130 with the tailwind instead of returning the same 70 nautical miles in the headwind. Time to ETP is simply the distance to ETP divided by the outbound speed, 0.53 hours or approximately 32 minutes. Once again, thank you for watching and be aware of your position in the air.